can you update us on the status of Rey Williams? How serious is his injury?
I will meet with the medical staff here at 1 o'clock, so you guys are just a little bit early. All right, so have more for you guys tomorrow.
After the original assessment, did it look bad for Rey Williams, or is there some positive in the air here?
As far as the assessment from the doctors, Well, first thing, just had swelling and different things. You know, I wasn't told anything bad. You know, it wasn't a fracture or anything like that. I think they had an x-ray out in Winnipeg. Just wanted to get some of the swelling down and see how he has a couple of days afterwards. So he's met with the doctor, and then I'll meet with those guys at 1, and then we'll be able to give you exactly what it is tomorrow, hopefully.
Who do you look as the next man up? Like, obviously, he won't play. I don't think he's going to play on the weekend. What if it's
Back, like, come back. No, well, you know, strange things have happened. But, you know, there's a number of guys. You know, Mike did a good job in finishing up for us, and there's just a couple of guys that, you know, we can rotate in there, you know. So we'll see how it goes this week, see how the roster shapes up, and see exactly who's able to fill that spot.
Did you consider bringing Abraham Cormier off the nine-game replacement?
He's a consideration also. Like I said, there's a couple of different guys that we've rotated that spot, you know, to make sure, to see exactly how they'll fit.
With possibly taking Abe Crom off, that means you can't take Chris Best off early if there's a chance at that. How much does that play into the decision?
Well, that's all a part of it, you know, when you look at it. Like I said, this is not something that we haven't thought about. You know, we've thought about each position and how it would affect us by who's on the nine game and who's not on the nine game. Some guys are in practice squad area, some guys have been in reserve, but we have a number of different guys to fill those roles.
Back to the game in Winnipeg. Was it hard to make adjustments for the offense to counteract that blitz?
You know, it's one of those things where it was pretty loud in there, you know. So anytime it's pretty loud and, you know, whether it's communication or anything to exactly say who's coming from where, that's always a tough situation. No different than, you know, any situation when you're on defense, it's a lot easier just to tee off when they can't communicate.
After watching the film more, what adjustments did they make last week and made them better?
You know, they just did a few more twists, a few more stunts on the defensive side. That's the biggest thing. And, you know, I think whatever they did in the kick return game, they changed a couple of guys here and there. But at the end of the day, like I said, they ended up with, I think, what, 8 sacks or somewhere like that. We ended up with 7. So it was just one of those things to where, you know, they played with the emotion and they were able to execute a little bit better.
Are you thinking of changing up the offensive line with Patrick Neufeld and Ben Heenan or not?
You know, like I said, I think those guys, when you look at it, Patty's played some guard for us now, and he's played some tackle for us. So we'll see during the week. We'll sit down. And there's a number of different things that we can do to try to help those guys.
I think he was thrust in that position a little too quickly. It took him 2 years to become an offensive tackle, and you made him a guard in a week.
He's a professional football player, O-lineman. Well, that's what he gets paid to do. Yeah.
How tough was that move, though, inside for him?
You know, I'm sure that's tough for a lot of different reasons. But at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what we actually play. Like one of the coaches said today about another player, we have to make sure that we line up and do our best. You know, like I said, and there are some things that we'll be able to do, I think, going forward to help those type guys.
How bad was communication for them out there? Even beside each other, they can almost hear Picard's calls.
I was screaming at George on the headphones and trying to ask him some questions, and we couldn't hear each other. It was pretty loud, you know, and I know if we have the microphones, how loud is it going to be when you're right next to each other?
Is that one of the loudest teams you ever coached in?
No, it's probably it's in the top two, all right, and it was the Eastern Final there a couple of years ago. They got pretty loud then.
Hey, Corey, how banged up is Darian Durant after taking all those hits?
Darian's taking some shots, but he's one of the thicker quarterbacks in the league. So, you know, and this is not the first time. So he knows that's a part of his job. He knows how he has to maintain his body. But at this point, you know, he got away pretty good, just probably sore in a couple of places.
Think of Dwight Anderson back on the weekend?
Say it again.
Will Dwight Anderson be back on the weekend?
Dwight should be back. You know, he talked to him today. His leg injury is doing pretty good and foot. So we should have him back and ready to roll.